What's going on, guys? Gino checking back in for another video today, and in this video I'm going to be taking you guys through another full day of eating on lean bulk, but this time intuitive eating style. Like I mentioned in one of the previous videos, I started following intuitive eating, which means that I don't track my macros on my FitnessPal, but I eat according to my intuition. And since I've been tracking my macros for like 5 strict straight years, I'm pretty much able to do so while still maintaining a lean physique and still add some muscle mass and some strength in the gym. So my estimated calories are at around 400 to 450 grams of carbs, around 70 or 80 grams of fat, and 190 grams of protein. Now, I have some set rules for myself so that I don't stray too far away from that macro target, but I'll go more in depth on that later in this video. So without further ado, physique update, and enjoy the video. Right, so here's a quick physique update on the lean bulk at 88 kilograms. So I'm 2 kilograms heavier than the last physique update. So as you can see, I'm pretty much maintaining some leanness while I'm still adding body weight and making hella progress in the gym. Alright, guys, here's what I have for breakfast. I have a bowl of oats with 40 grams of whey, 2 bananas, and some chocolate sprinkles to top it off. A legendary Nutella sandwich, a cup of morning coffee, and some water. Alright, guys, it's time for the second meal of the day. Now, I'm making a conscious effort to keep my carbs on the high end, so I'm basically adding high carb sources or a lot of a carb source into my meals so that I know that my carbs are pretty high towards my end of the range. What I have right here is a container of quark, 500 grams, which comes down to 45 grams of protein. And underneath that, I have 250 grams of mixed frozen berries, the micronutrients obviously. And I have 3 rice cakes. Now these are 7.5 grams of carb per rice cake, so that's, let me see, so that's around 22 grams of carbs right here. And in between that, I have in total 30 grams of peanut butter for a fat source. And then I'm going to be adding 60 grams of the zero sugar gingerbread in the bowl of quark and frozen fruit. Now, purely for the fact that I don't want to run into the low end of any macro target, so say for example fat, I'm making conscious effort to add a fat source to every meal that I eat. So for this meal, it's going to be peanut butter, and 30 grams of peanut butter is already like anywhere between 15 or 20 grams of fat, so that's a pretty huge fat source, and that allows me to hit my fat goal for the day more easily. And the same obviously goes for protein. So like I said, this is 45 grams of protein just from the quark, and then obviously the rice cakes have a little bit of protein, the fruit has a little bit of protein, and the same goes for the zero sugar gingerbread. And by having a source of fat, a big source of carbs, and a source of protein with every single meal that I eat, I know from estimating the numbers and knowing how much protein, fat, and carb everything that I have in these meals have, I'm hitting my targets easily. Since I've been tracking these foods for a long time, I'm talking years, I know the amount of fat, carbs, and protein in those individual products, so I can estimate and guess where I'm at for that particular meal.
You like how I exist? I'm actually fine with it, man. Still having a good time. You're having a good time, man.
Today is a lower body deadlift day. I noticed that I haven't put up some sumo deadlifting footage in a long while. I believe it's been a couple of months. I'm going to be taking you guys through the workout and give some tips on the exercises itself, and specifically the deadlift, since I've had some requests for deadlift form. I'm gonna take you guys with me and head to the gym for legs.
I'm tipping.
See you mine?
Yeah.
Alright, so I want to give a big little tip on deadlift, and especially since I'm doing sumo, I want to give a tip on the sumo deadlift. What goes wrong for a lot of people, which actually allows people to have a really fucked up back when they're deadlifting, is putting the slack out of the bar. And I'll show you that in just a minute. A lot of people forget to do before they push the weight, pull the weight from the floor, is hearing this little sound right here. The reason that you have to hear this little sound, which is putting the slack out of the bar, is simply because you're then engaging your legs and putting yourself in the proper or correct position to initiate the deadlift on its own. If I want to pick up the weight from the let-go and basically not put the slack out of the bar, I'm simply forcing my lower back to round over, simply because I'm not engaged like this. So I'm gonna do one example rep right here as the last block. So I'm positioning my feet, the sumo positioning, taking a deep breath, putting the slack out. And that's that. So when I'm putting the slack out, I'm engaging my lats with the movement, with the deadlift, and allowing myself to have a straight back and really use my hips with the sumo deadlift. And probably the biggest tip that I can give for sumo deadlift, of course, same goes for a conventional. Putting the slack out allows you to stay in a proper position.
So I just had my dinner, which were a sort of hash browns or little diced up potatoes baked in some butter, a chicken breast and some peas and carrots. Now my dinners are usually always different since I live at home and my mom cooks. So I basically eat whatever my mom cooks for me, but it's most of the time always something in the range of what I just ate, but varying vegetables. I'm actually going to be doing some boxing right now, which is something I've never actually done before, or actually like have a dedicated session towards boxing. So we'll see how it goes, and I will take you guys with me. Just came fresh out the shower, as you can see, and it's time for the last meal of the day, which is also actually the post cardio workout meal. Alright, so for the last meal of the day, I have quite a little feast right here. Now I'm going to be taking out 30 to 35 grams of almonds, which comes down to about 17 grams of fat, or 70 up to 20 grams of fat straight from almonds. So that's a main fat source for this meal. Another container of quark, 500 grams, which is 45 grams of protein and around 20 grams of carbs. Now, like I said, these were around 7 grams of carbs per serving per rice cake, so that's 7, 14, 21, 28 grams of carbs. And then I have 3 pieces of zero sugar gingerbread, which are 16 grams of carbs each, so that's 16, 32, and around 48, I believe, grams of carbs added. And to finish it off, I have a protein bar with, let me see, 20 grams of protein, 8.7 grams of fat, and 16.7 grams of carbohydrates. Now this about caps off my macros for the day. Even when I'm estimating my macro and caloric intake, I'm pretty much at a range, since I know from experience how much carbs, fats, and protein, and logically calories, all the foods have that I eat. So it's not really guessing work for me, it's more of a standard routine. I've eaten these foods so many times that I actually know the macronutrient profile out of my head, basically, and I can pretty much apply common knowledge to my dietary approach. So that concludes my full day of eating on the lean bulk while intuitively eating. I sincerely hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please be sure to smash the like button, because it really helps out the channel grow. Comment down below and subscribe to the channel for so much more content coming really soon. I'm out, guys, and peace out. See you in the next one.